morning to you all. I hope you are well and fine at your home and staying safe. Students, today we are going to start with the very new topic of ours, that is conjunction, lesson number 13. Do you know what are conjunctions? Conjunctions basically are the joining words. The word con and junction are made from the word, that is con means joint and junction means together. So conjunction is a word that basically means join together. Conjunction is a very important topic and a very important part of the speech. So here students, it is used for basically joining two sentences, phrases, words together. There are some important conjunctions which I have written here, like for, but, till, although, or, so, as, yet, if, because, and many more. These are all words that tie the sentences together, that join them together. Let's do the definition of conjunctions. A conjunction is a word that joins words or sentences together. For example, students, if we want to write two different sentences, it shortens the word by combining them as one. Let's do it through the example. For example, first, he is clever but lazy boy. We have used here but. For example, student, let us think that we have written, he is clever boy, he is lazy boy. Now, here, but denotes the contradiction between the two sentences. Like, one is saying the positive thing and another word is saying the negative one. So, if it's written, he is a clever boy, he is a lazy boy, why we have to write it as a longer one? We use some conjunction in between it. For example, he is clever. For contradiction, we will use but as a conjunction. He is clever but lazy boy. So here, but is used as a conjunction. Second example, I like mangoes and bananas. So here, and is used for the similar things we like. For example, I like mangoes, I like bananas. I like two things at a time. So why to write the longer sentence? We'll shorten it by using a conjunction. And we have used and for similar things. Like, I like mangoes and bananas. Got it? Now the third example. You can come if you like. So here we have used if. Where is if used? If is used where the condition is taking place. Like, you can come. You can come to the place if you like. If you like. Then if you like, you can come here. So here, there is a condition. Okay? So we have used a conjunction, that is if, to shorten the sentence. So students, this is the description of the conjunction. We'll discuss it with further through some examples and doing proper exercises. So students, let's start with the conjunctions, but before starting the exercises, let's introduce it once again. As I've already told you, that conjunction are the joining words. They join words or sentences together. So here are different conjunctions like yet,
for, and, so, but, or, because, nor. We'll discuss them one by one. So here, so is used for showing the result of something. For example, he was very hungry, so he ate all the cake. So in this way, so is used. Next is but. As I've already told you, that but is used for the contrast. For example, I eat cake, but I never eat biscuits. So there's a contrast between the sentences. Next is for. For is used for giving a reason, for explaining why. For example, he's overweight, for he eats too many cakes. So it's giving the reason. And as I've already told you, is used for similar sentences like I like mangoes and bananas. So for similar sentences, and is used. Next is nor. Nor is used for two non-contrasting, grammatically negative items. For example, both the sentences are negative. He doesn't eat cake, nor he eat biscuits. He doesn't eat cakes, nor he eat biscuits. Next one is or. Or is used for choices that you make. Did you like tea or coffee? Do you like tea or coffee? Next one is yet. Yet is a contrast despite something. For example, there is a contrast despite of something happening. So, for example, we can say he's overweight and feels terrible. Yet, he continues to eat lots of cake. So, here we can use yet. And the last one is because. Because is used for a reason. He is crying because he fell down. So these are the conjunction words which are used for joining a noun, word, sentences or phrases together. So students, please take out this English grammar book, New First Lessons in English Grammar, and take out page number 31. We'll start with exercise 1. Exercise 1 is about picking out conjunctions in the following sentences. There are different sentences given and we have to pick out the conjunction. The first one is, he is clever but lazy boy. So where's the conjunction? So here, but is the conjunction. Next, I waited till the train arrived. I waited for the train till it arrived. So here, what's the conjunction? Till is the conjunction specifying the time. The man died before the doctor arrived. So here is again specified the time when the man died, before the arriving of the doctor. So here the conjunction is before. So the next one is fourth part. Rama failed because he was idle. So here they are giving a reason by using because. So because is the conjunction. Fifth, she is kind and loving mother. So here and is used when similar sentences are being used. So here and is conjunction. Sixth part, you must work harder or I shall punish you. So there both are choices, that the person must work harder or he'll get punished. So here the conjunction used is or. I ran fast but missed the train. So here they are the contrasting ones. They use but. So the conjunction is but. There's a contrast between the two sentences that we ran fast but missed the train. Eighth, I know that he is ill. Students, when somewhere the fact is being given that I know he is ill. So here that is the conjunction. So ninth part, the mice will play when the cat is away. So here the timing is given, when the mice will play, when the cat is away. So the conjunction is when. They are poor yet contented. So here I have told you that yet is used with the contrast despite of something. So here the conjunction is yet. 11th part, don't answer unless you know. Here there's a condition, that is unless. So here the conjunction is unless. 12th, he will help you if you ask him. So there's a condition, when we will help you, if he will ask him. So the conjunction is if. 13th part, he will never succeed although he works hard. So here there's a condition despite of something he is doing. So here the conjunction is although. Next come to the 14th part. 14th is ask him whether he wishes to go or not. So here there's another condition, ask him whether he wishes to go or not, that if he wants to go or not. So here there's a condition, that is whether. 15th, you can come if you like. I've already discussed you in the example. So here if is the condition, so here the conjunction is if. 16th part, there dwelt Milo, hale and bold. So here the conjunction is and. 17th and the last part of the first exercise, his petticoats now George cast off for he was 4 years old. So here the conjunction is for, as it's giving the reason behind it. So here in the 17th, the conjunction is for. Students, now let's come to the second part of the exercise. Here we have to fill each blank of the following sentences with appropriate conjunction. So students, now the first part is, he is old but strong. Why I have used but? Because the two contrast sentences are there. He is old, but in spite of that, he is strong. So here we have used but. Second, work hard unless or you will fail. Work hard unless / or you will fail. You can write here both the answers because both are giving either the choices or the conditions. Okay. Third, the train was derailed but no one got hurt. The train was derailed but no one was hurt. So here there is a contrast between the two sentences. That's why we have used here but. Now fourth part, 2 and 3 makes 5. So here both similar sentences are used and for the combination we are using and. Fifth part, you will get the prize if you work hard. So here the condition is given, when you will get the prize, if you work hard. Sixth part, I spoke to him but he did not answer. So here there's a contradiction. I spoke to him, but the answer is not being given. So seventh, wait here until I come back. So here there's a timing given. Wait here until I come back. So here until is the answer. Now let's come to the eighth part. Be just and fear not. Be just means be honest and fear not. So here both the sentences have the similar meaning, similar condition. So we are using and here. Ninth part. He was punished. The reason is being given. He was guilty. So when the reason is given, we are using because as a conjunction. Very right. He was punished because he was guilty. Tenth part. There is no doubt that the earth is round. So here the fact is given and it's true that the earth is round. That's why that is used. 11th. Will you kindly wait till I return? So here again the timing is specified that will you kindly wait till I return. So here the fill-up is till. 12th part. Catch me if you can. So here the condition is denoted that catch me if you can. If is the condition. So here the answer is if. 13th part. The grasshopper would not have starved in winter if she had not been lazy all summer. So here again the condition is being given with the grasshopper who would not have starved in winter if she had not been lazy all the summer. So the answer is if. 14th part. We saw the lightning and we heard the thunder. So here both the sentences are of the similar kind. So that's why we have put and as fill-ups, which is the conjunction. 15th part. I will go away if you do not want me. So here again the condition is being given. I'll go away if you do not want me. So here if is the condition. Now let's come to the 16th part. The tortoise bit the hare, though the hare was swifter of the two. So here, though is used when there is a contrast despite of some condition. That is, you all know that the tortoise speed is very slow and the hare moves swiftly. But in spite of that, the tortoise won the race. So here, though is being used for the tortoise because he has bet the hare as the hare was swifter of the two. So here, though is used as the conjunction. 17th part. I shall be surprised if you fail. So here the condition is given that the person will get surprised if the another person fails. So here if is used. 18th part. Cats can climb trees but dogs cannot. We all know cats can climb trees but dogs cannot. So here the contrast of the sentences is given. That's why we are using but as a conjunction. 19th part. He has succeeded better than he hoped. So here, why we have used then? Because we are comparing these two sentences. He has succeeded better than he hoped. 20th part. We can travel by land or by water. So students, we all know that we can travel by one means in a time. So here the choice is being given, and for the choices I have already told you that we can use or as a conjunction. Very true. 21st. He has read much though he is young. He has read much because in the younger age the students are not able to read much, but despite of being something there's a contrast. So here we can use though as a sentence because despite of being something, someone is given. Something is given. 22nd. I am sorry if you are offended. I am sorry if you are offended. If is the condition. So here, that's why we have used if, as he is sorry if he gets offended. So if is used. So now students, come to exercise number 3, that is join the following pairs of sentences together by means of a suitable conjunction. As I've already told you that there will be given two sentences, and after the first sentence, we have to put that type of a suitable conjunction that the sentence should be shortened. It gets meaningful. So students, let's start with the first one. He is rich, full stop. He is not happy, full stop. So here, one is the positive and another one is the negative. So when the contrast is given, we will put but in between. Okay, we'll put but in between. He is rich but not happy. So here we'll use but as a conjunction and join the two sentences. Second part, you must be quiet, you must leave the room. So here she has put a condition that if you can't get quiet, you must leave the room. So when these type of sentences come, we use otherwise as a conjunction. You must be quiet, otherwise you must leave the room. Third part, he forgave him, he was sorry. Why he forgave him? Because he was sorry. So here the reason is given. So we are using here because. Okay. Now the fourth part. He put in his thumb, he pulled out a plum. So here both the sentences are giving the positive vibes. So when both the sentences are in the positive and the similar manner, we'll use and in between. We'll use and. He put in his thumb and pulled out a plum. Now let's come to the fifth part. Rama works hard, dot. Hari is idle, dot. Rama works hard, but Hari is idle. Why I have used but in between? Because one is positive, he is working hard, that's good. But Hari is remaining idle, he is remaining free, he is not doing anything. So here, but is used for the contrast between the two sentences. Next, sixth part. He was afraid of being late, full stop, he ran. So, he ran. I have used here so. He was afraid of being late, so he ran. So is also used as in because it's giving a reason. Okay? Seventh, I stumbled, full stop, I was going downstairs. Stumbled means you would attempt it to fell down, but you don't. Okay, I stumbled when I was going downstairs. So here you are denoting the time when you stumbled, when you were going downstairs. So here we'll use when as a conjunction. I stumbled when I was going downstairs. 8. Balu made 12 runs. He was caught at the wicket. So here Balu made 12 runs before he was caught at the wicket. Because he has already made 12 runs. After that, he was caught at the wicket. Caught at the wicket means he was out. So here, it's the timing given. So here, we'll use before. Okay? 9. He did not succeed. He worked hard. He did not succeed, although he worked hard. Because it's a positive reason given, but at the same time, the reason was not fulfilled. That's why we use although. He did not succeed, although he worked hard. Now let's come to the 10th part. I lost the prize, I tried my best. Similarly, there is the negative part. He tried to do his best, but in spite of that, he didn't got any prize. So here we'll use although. I lost the prize, although I tried my best. In these type of sentences, we always use although. if we have tried our best, if we have tried to do something, but the situation go in spite of all these things. It does not work in our control. That's why we use although. 11th part. We are not going out. It is raining. So we have already given the reason here. We are not going out because it is raining. 12th part. I honor him. He is a brave man. Similarly, there is a reason given. I honor him because he is a brave man. So here, because is used. He sat down. He was tired. He sat down because he was tired. Another reason is being given. That is because he was tired. Okay. 14th part. He must start at once. He will be late. Another. He must start at once. There's a condition given. He must start at once. He had told. Otherwise, he will be late. Otherwise, he will be late. The conjunction we use is otherwise. So, because firstly, we have told about something that we have to start this thing at once. Now here, what's the opposite condition which is not in favor? Otherwise, that person will be late. So we have used here otherwise. Now the 15th part. I shall go, you will allow me. I shall go when you will allow me. So here the timing is denoted. That's why we have used when. I shall go when you will allow me. 16th. We have not seen him. He returned from England. We have not seen him since he had returned from England. So here the timing is being denoted that at by what time he had not seen him. How much time has it been there? So since he has returned from England, by the time he has returned from England, from that time onwards he had not seen him. So that why we have used here since. Okay. Now the 17th part. He must do as he is told. Full stop. He'll be punished. So here the choices are being given. He must do as he is told, or he'll be punished. Whenever the choices will come, you have to use or. 18th part. He is ill. I know it. So here the fact is being denoted that he is ill. So we can say that I know. Firstly, we have to use the second part of the sentence. Then we have to put that as a conjunction. And then the first part as it is. I know that he is ill. 19th part. Rama failed. He was idle. So here the proper reason is being denoted. Rama failed. Why he failed? Because he was idle. So here the reason is given. So here we have used the conjunction because. Now the 20th part. Did he act wisely? Question mark. Did he act foolishly? Question mark. So here both the questions are being given. But there is a choice that if we act wisely or foolishly. When the choices are given, we will put or as a conjunction. Did he act wisely or did he act foolishly? Okay, students. Now the 21st part. This mango is large. Full stop. This mango is sweet. So here, similar type of sentences are being given. So why to longer them? We have to shorten them as one by putting a suitable conjunction. And for the similar sentences, I have already told you that we'll put and. This mango is large and sweet. 22nd. Mother is at home. Father is at home. So here, both are at home. Similar type of sentences are there. So we'll join them as one. Mother and father. Now, more than one person, I have already told you we have to use are. We will use are. Mother and father are at home. Okay. So here, and is the conjunction. 23rd and the last part of the last exercise, number 3rd. You are tall, full stop. My brother is taller. You are tall, but my brother is taller. Why we have used but? Because there is a contrast between these two sentences. You are tall, but your brother is taller than you. Okay? You are tall, but your brother is taller than your height. So here we have used but as a sentence. So it is all done with all the three exercises.
So students, this is all with the exercises. Today we have done three exercises. In the first exercise, we had pick out the conjunctions or underline them. Okay? We have to identify the conjunctions and picked out. In the second exercise, we fill up all the conjunctions which are suitable to it. And in the third one, there were two different sentences and we have joined them by using different conjunctions which are suitable. So students, conjunction is the very important part in the English grammar, which is helped to shorten out the sentence. A conjunction is a word which joins words or sentences together. We can use different conjunctions in our daily life to make our English very simpler and easier. Students, always remember, as glue is to paper, conjunction is to words. It can make English simpler, easier in all kinds of terms. Thank you.